And Anthony Beshara in the studio.
Beshara.
And Anthony Beshara in the studio. We got Fred Baxter in the studio. Tight end for the New York Jets, Chicago Bears, New England Patriots, and Washington Redskins. And promoter of the Fred Baxter Golf Tournament, which is going to be happening this Monday. You could be playing golf with Wayne Krabet, Joe and Dan Klecko, Mike Quick, Mike Rozier, Paul Miles, Dr. Len Bernan, and the proceeds benefit the Fred Baxter Foundation, which was founded to support the academic and physical development of disadvantaged youths and families nationwide. You take care of everybody. I got to ask you about kids playing football. How do you feel about it? How old should a child be before they really start getting into competitive football?
That's a great question, and I'm an advocate for football because it changed my life. I'm an ambassador for the Heads Up USA football program the NFL has.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, I'm an ambassador. And very fortunate, tomorrow going down to Congress and giving a clinic on safety, how we can make a physical game safer, not safe. Because you can't make a physical game safe.
Right.
But we can make it safer. And it's teaching the kids the proper techniques, tackling and blocking.
Now, that's the NFL has put a lot of time and effort into this, especially with all the concussion information that's come out in the last few years. They have clinics for the coaches to go to, which take about 90 minutes, and they're trained or certified to be able to coach kids.
Yes. Yes. You have youth and you have high school certifications. And you know, the youth in the high school certification is similar, but in high school, it's a little bit more complicated than the youth.
And, right.
But at the same time, in the youth, we are teaching them the proper and the, you know, right way to play football. And, you know, and like I said, it's a physical game. You can't make it safe. You can try to make it safer by educating and making sure that everyone is on the same page, the parents, the coaches, and the players, you know, in the line of communications. And when you're talking about the Heads Up program, you know, you got to have, you know, a protocol when you're talking about that cardiac arrest, you know. And you know, it's happening because it's the time of the season. It's hot. Mm-hmm. And everyone have to be on the same page and making sure that it's seamless. And that's what the Heads Up program does. That's one of the components, you know, of making sure that everyone is on the same page if it's an emergency happening on the field.
How different was it, like, when you were coming up, when you were playing, and, you know, especially playing in the heat? You know, two-a-days, you thought nothing about going out there, and you think about the time you put in when you were pro, but even when you were a kid and practicing in the Alabama heat. And today, just like you said, how much safer it is for kids.
You know, acclimation is very key in one of the components, and you have to, you know, gradually, you know, you have to work in the elements, but you have to be very, very vigilant of what you're doing with these kids. You know, you got to make sure to have, they're hydrated. You make sure you got to have water. And all my camps and the camps that I participate in, you know, the kids, you have your own water break. Whenever you feel that you thirsty, it's too late. So we got to make sure you continue to hydrate. You know, it's very key.
That's a very good point. When you're thirsty, it's too late. Now, how old would you say, like, how old should a kid be? Should a boy or girl be before they begin playing football?
Well, with the program, with the Heads Up, we have flag where we introduce you. You have kids, you know, that, you know, third, fourth grade. But, you know, it's more flag where it's more instructional.
Right.
And then and as you gradually go through the program, now you're getting the equipment, then now it changes. You know, you're talking about sixth, seventh, eighth graders. Then now you're talking about really getting some good teaching of youth, of getting good sound fundamentals in football.
And when you coach the kids, right, the hardest thing to get them to do is the fundamentals. Just to do it over and over and over and learn it because they want to play.
You have to practice the fundamentals every day. And you have to have creative ways. You know, when you're talking about sixth and seventh, eighth graders, they love competition. So if you make it competitive, instructional but competitive, you get the best out of them.
And you get their respect because they'll listen to you.
Yeah, they want ownership. You want leadership. You want to be a leader. You know, you want them to step up. You want them to, you know, do the best. You want them to, you know, to make sound decisions. You want to add all of that into it. Then now you're creating a great athlete, student athlete.
Right. Now, when it comes to golf, Anthony, and how old would you say a child should be when they're mentally ready to play golf, physically able to do it?
I've seen members bring their kids out as young as three.
Three? Remember Tiger Woods, the old, like, yeah, the clips of him at five going around on the Mike Douglas show and stuff?
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah. They go on the driving range. They go on the putting green. They start them very, very early. There's a couple of families at Bella Vista that they're there every single day, 6 days a week from, I would say, from 4 o'clock with the fundamentals. Exactly what they start them on the driving range. Then they move over to the putting green. And then they do 9 holes of golf every day. It's like a 3 or 4 hour regimen with them.
And, you know, you don't realize that when you're that young and you start, that this is a game that it's the one game you can play for the rest of your life. You could play it into your 70s. You could play it as long as you can stand. Of all the sports, that's the one that you'll always be able to do.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I had a gentleman, 83 years old, beat my butt. So I'm talking about got me good.
Show him the ring. That's okay.
He said, son, this ain't football. It's the grass, but it's not football.
Was it one of our members?
No.
Because the members of the club wait for Fred. Yeah, he goes out and plays with them a lot. My cousin Gary, of course, goes out and plays with him. Gary has the advantage. He plays my cousin, and I don't play at all.
You don't play at all?
Yes, I watch them drive by on the golf cart. That's how I
But you get the nice golf tan. That's good. You get to eat. That's good. And then I'll be waiting for you back at the clubhouse.
Something like that. Yeah.
It's always good like that.